The recent conflict between Israel and militants in the Gaza Strip has brought into focus increasing competition by regional powers to influence Gaza's Hamas leadership. In particular, support from Iran for the Islamist group has proven stronger than ever, with officials in Tehran boasting about the country's role as the builder of Hamas's rocket arsenal. Iranian General Mohammad Ali Jafari, the head of the Revolutionary Guard, recently said Iran supplied fighters in Gaza with the technology to quickly produce Fajr 5 missiles, which are able to reach as far as Tel Aviv. While Iran denies that it directly supplies Hamas's military wing with rockets, rocket parts have been smuggled from Iran through tunnels that run between Gaza and Egypt's Sinai Peninsula. The supply of weapons technology is part of Iran's strategy to equip anti-Israel factions in Gaza, as well as militant group Hezbollah in Lebanon on Israel's northern border. Some have speculated that Israel's material support for the Islamist group tempered what many expected to be widespread popular anger over Israel's campaign targeting Gaza militants and their rocket arsenals. Iranian interference in the wave of revolutionary protests that swept the region, as well as its meddling in the ongoing civil war in Syria, have fueled Arab animosity toward Tehran, and it's unclear if Iran's support for Palestinian groups has done much to change that. Also vying for influence in the region is hyper-rich Qatar, which has proven itself a formidable political and economic lifeline for Hamas. Last month, the country's emir became the first head of state to visit the Gaza Strip since Hamas took control 5 years ago, pledging $500 million in aid. Whatever the case, it's clear that the competition for influence is set to intensify, a competition that not only pits Iran and Arab groups against each other, but also looks set to raise the profile of Gaza throughout the region.